AWA Legends is brought to you by your local Mitsubishi dealers.
Yeah, everyone talks pretty tough about their SUVs. Off-road prowess, blah, blah, blah. But here's the thing. We don't have to. See, only Mitsubishi has won the Paris to Dakar Rally 5 times. And right now, you can lease a new 99 Montero Sport LS four-wheel drive for just $289 a month for 42 months. As for all our competitors' tough talk...
is sanctioned by the AWA, the American Wrestling Association. All-Star Wrestling presents the top professional wrestlers from the United States, Canada, England, Germany, Australia, Mexico, Hope, Japan. The greatest professional wrestlers from throughout the world. And now to the ring for All-Star Action.
Welcome to the AWA Legends, and this week I hope we get our revenge.
Well, if you don't know by now, I guess you never will. But that match you're going to have, I think during in that match, we saw some great moves by you and Jim, especially what I call wrestling moves. And you paid your price because you brought that old barn in Chanhassen that we had for our training headquarters, you and Jim Brunzell and a number of others. But you hung in there for about a year before you got a chance to really wrestle. And you learned your lessons well. You and Jim became a great team that became world champions. So you did pay the price.
Well, it was the hardest thing I ever did. 6 hours a day, 6 days a week with that one little light bulb above the ring and out there in November and December. And
right.
Billy Robinson slamming us down on that mat. Your bones just...
Well, it was a tough training camp. We always had a tough training camp. But the people we turned out of that training camp came out and became first-rate specialists.
Well, I hate blowing our own horns here, but I do want to congratulate you, Dad. This is a tremendous honor. Newton, Iowa, April 23rd, 24th, you're going to be inducted into the Professional Wrestling Hall of Fame,
right,
along with Lou Fez, Ed Stranger Lewis, and Carl Gotch.
Frank Gotch, our first world champion back in the early 1900s, 1906 to 1911. Ed Stranger Lewis came along, won the titles, I think, in the 20s and into the 30s. Lou Fez into the 30s, 40s, and 50s. And then, of course, I was
50s, 60s, 70s, 80s. How about the 90s?
Well, it didn't quite hit the 90s, but
probably will.
It's going to be a great night, and I really appreciate being inducted into that Hall of Fame. It's very, very nice.
Well, good. Congratulations. We'll get to all the action today. We've got some great, great action coming up. But first, a word from our sponsors, Mitsubishi.
All right. You know that old saying, you get what you pay for? Well, whoever said that, obviously, never heard this. Right now, you can lease a new 99 Mitsubishi Galante E for just $209 a month for 39 months. That's the best new car in its class, according to Kiplinger's magazine, with one of the lowest lease payments in its class. Yeah, sometimes you get what you pay for.
Who were the first to be recognized as AWA's tag team champions? Crusher and Bruiser, Hard-Boiled Haggerty and Gene Snitsky, Tiny Mills and Stan Kowalski, or Vern Gagne and Leo Nomalini?
My fondest memories would probably be watching Greg Gagne and Jim Brunzell, the High Flyers. Really enjoyed them. I enjoyed everybody at that time. I grew up with all these guys. And now I'm getting my son into it.
Oh, they were good. Jim Brunzell and Greg Gagne were good as a team, and they fought a lot of hard battles. I used to like them.
Gene Okerlund along with you, and it's great to have Marty O'Neill. Behind a microphone with us, I know that for so many, many years, all around the country, you fans, heard Marty's commentary. You saw and heard his interviews with top stars from days gone by. Marty's still a big part of what goes on in professional wrestling behind the scenes. Look at that knee. Did you see that? I'll tell you, that absolutely level Rick Martel. Jimmy Brunzell going up in the air and really, really demolished Rick Martel. Martel, very, very groggy, but I don't know. Brunzell going to run into a little trouble with a backbreaker. One, two, kick out. I'll tell you, Martel and Santana with those quick tags, really working on their opposition. There's another backbreaker and a duke out again. There's the abdominal stretch, Tito Santana with the abdominal stretch to Greg Gagne. Tremendously painful. Hold, and you can see the pain etched deep on the face of Greg Gagne. Referee checking with Gagne on a submission. Santana, the abdominal stretch. You can see Martel in the background of the foreground, Jimmy Brunzell. He's got to hang out of that rope, though, or the tag will not be legal. And this referee is Ben Friedman out of Milwaukee, Wisconsin, officiating this match tonight. I'll tell you, really on top of things. I don't think you're going to get too much past this caliber of referee. Well, Gagne may be coming up with a counter. As soon as I say it, it happens. Greg Gagne takes Santana up and over. Able to muster up enough to get him out of that abdominal stretch and a tag quickly. Tito Santana to Rick Martel. Martel trying to maneuver Gagne into the Boston Crab, and he has done so. A couple of submission holds in succession, and you can see the concern as Brunzell out of the ring apron jumping up and down. Martel, perfect execution of the Boston Crab in just that quick. Greg Gagne manages to counter. Martel setting Gagne up with a suplex and a takedown, and indeed, a two count.
Lunchtime, 25 minutes.
Tito Santana setting up Gagne for another atomic drop. And that one takes Gagne off his feet. Well, Santana trying to come up with a victory roll on a two count again. They've done everything, I must say. Santana and Martel have done everything but get a three count out of the high flyer. Well, it should be pointed out, Marty O'Neill, that's the reason. Greg Gagne and Jim Brunzell are the tag team champions of the world.
And, James, can you imagine, 25 minutes gone by, about 27 now, these four have been going at top speed. What tremendous condition they've got to be in.
And I'll tell you, Marty, just as I walked in tonight, temperature of 80 degrees, tremendous humidity in the air, and out of the capacity crowd in here tonight, these young gentlemen are working up under those lights in that ring at temperatures that are probably somewhere in the neighborhood of 100 degrees.
They have my 100% admiration, because these kids haven't slowed down for one single second. As you said, move and counter move.
Well, that was very, very close to two count as Martel tried for the pin of Greg Gagne. Quick tag, Martel to Tito Santana. Santana into the ring right now. Trying to line Greg Gagne up. Gagne trying now, both men going back and forth, up and over on that pickup. Tito Santana taking down Greg Gagne. High in the air. Another one count. Still not able to bring home victory. Another quick tag from Santana to Martel. And now this crowd starts to come to life. Oh, ladies and gentlemen, some kind of action. Greg Gagne with a roundhouse right and a reverse knife edge. Martel tried to come back, but look at Gagne going to work. Ducks under, rolls over, comes over the tag to Jim Brunzell. Having an opportunity to rest, a quick uppercut of the Opro. Brunzell in the air, a flying dropkick that levels Martel. Here he goes for the pickup, up, and over, high in the air. Listen to this crowd respond. One, two, quick count. Tito Santana comes in. Jimmy Brunzell with a series of uppercuts. Santana on the rope. Here's the whip. Well, he tried to take him over with a back body drop, but those two men collided. And Santana is in trouble. I can't help but believe he's not on the verge of exhaustion at the tremendous pace that they set from the very opening sound of the bell, the opening moments of this match. It has truly been spectacular.
Well, a moment ago, it looked like two trains met head-on when they collided. Both were hurt. No, there's a tag off to Greg now because Brunzell was definitely shaken up. The first man came in, but Gagne came in. Here they go.
Hold the phone. That's Martel in there, and all of a sudden, Greg Gagne with the Gagne sleeper, made famous by his father, the great Stern Gagne. But take a look at this seesaw battle back and forth. Gagne with a sleeper, Martel with a backbreaker. One, two. I'm telling you, this is something else. Martel trying for the Irish whip. Look at this, up in the air, one, two. First, the Irish whip reversed. Santana with a tank for Martel in. A couple of consecutive drop kicks that level Greg Gagne. And there is the flying body block. One, two, kick out. Now time for the victory roll. Tito Santana, this thing seesawing back and forth. One of the greatest matches I have seen. The tag Gagne to Brunzell immediately. Wait a second. Holy cow. Ladies and gentlemen, Marty O'Neill, you said that could be it, and indeed it could.
He went out there head first, and he may be badly hurt, may not get back by the count of 10. If he doesn't, it's all over.
Tito Santana trying to get to Jimmy Brunzell with a flying body block. He went over the top rope. He landed out on the arena floor, and the match has been called. Tito Santana may be hurt. Tito Santana, spectacular, over the top rope, out onto that hard arena floor. He could not answer the pin count.
And so, champion, at 29 minutes, 47 seconds, our players, Greg Gagne and Jim Brunzell.
All right, 29:47, nearly a half hour under these conditions. A tremendous pace from the outset.
Who were the first official AWA Tag Team Champions? In August of 1960, Tiny Mills and Stan Kowalski, also known as Murder Incorporated, were awarded the first AWA Tag Team belt.
Hi, this is Greg Gagne, and I want to take a minute to thank our major sponsor, your local Mitsubishi dealership. It's only with their help that we can bring back the stars of the AWA. I drive a Montero Sport, my wife, the all-new Gallant, and my dad, the full-size Montero. So we can all speak to the quality of the Mitsubishi vehicle. I invite you all to visit one of your Mitsubishi dealers today. There's one in your neighborhood. To the west, see Wayzata Mitsubishi. To the south, see Bloomington Metro Mitsubishi. In Brooklyn Center, see Brookdale Metro Mitsubishi. In St. Cloud, see McKay's Family Mitsubishi. And for our friends in St. Paul, there's Klein Mitsubishi. Saturday is always a great day to shop, and the Mitsubishi dealers are making it easy to buy or lease by offering no money down finance plans on any new car or truck in stock today. Come see the entire lineup at a dealer near you. And who knows, you may walk home with the champions of the AWA poster just like this. Thank you, Mitsubishi. We appreciate your help in bringing back the AWA to Minnesota.
Their quick moves and flying drop kicks earned Greg Gagne and Jumpin' Jim Brunzell this week's Flash of the Week.
Your morning commute without splash window washer.
Hey, buddy, get off the road!
Your morning commute with splash windshield washer. Next time, use splash windshield washer and splash de-icer for safe driving in ice and freezing rain and a relaxing commute.
Oh, I tell you, this has been something since the opening bell, even before the opening bell. Oh, if you weren't here, you missed it. And Greg Gagne gets brained by Adonis. Greg has been cut. inside this. Cyclone fence, and he gets rammed head on into the fence. A cover by Adonis Connett. Well, two. He went over to tag the. He thought that Jesse Ventura was his partner. He's really groggy. Brunzell trying to. Boatman. One, two. Boatman boomeranged him into the fence. Greg hammers him from the floor. Ventura's going to ram him into the fence again. Greg Gagne really cut. He comes back with a vicious roundhouse forearm. Gets a Dennis. A kick. Jump. And this young man is fighting on pure instinct.
Yeah, everyone talks pretty tough about their SUVs. Off-road prowess, blah, blah, blah. But here's the thing. We don't have to. See, only Mitsubishi has won the Paris to Dakar rally 5 times. And right now, you can lease a new 99 Montero Sport LS four-wheel drive for just $289 a month, 42 months. As for all our competitors' tough talk...
Hey, Minnesota, show us your splash.
Splash when you miss you, getting dirty just to fly a little splash. I was driving in my car, I could hardly see. Oh, my windshield was so dirty by that foreign from me. So I tried a little
windshield washer and streak-free splash de-icer, which also removes frost and light ice to 30 below. Show us your splash.
Gagne gives him the fence. No time limit. All the way across. As Ventura gets raked. Gets his head raked against that fence. I think he's got his nose stuck in there. And Greg Gagne hammers him into the ring post. Not the ring post, the vertical post on the fence. Oh, good heavens. Greg gets out. I'll tell you, this has been going like this since the opening bell. I think Brunzell may have hurt his hand on that one. I don't know. Jesse is all... Oh, Jesse is bleeding. Jesse Ventura. He's bleeding profusely. So is Greg Gagne. Down you want, Ventura. The title is not at stake in this one. The commission would not approve a title bout. And Gagne goes after Ventura. I'll tell you, Ventura's really cut badly. Hey, there's a cover by Greg Gagne. One. Adonis. Saving Ventura. Sam Mutchnick from St. Louis, AWA representative ringside. Look at that. Greg gave him a kick in the gut. Tag off from Zellin. Adonis tried to get out. A leg smash, Brunzell! A suplex by Brunzell! A cover! Ventura interrupts. Oh, and now Brunzell goes after Ventura. Oh, and Madonna should have let it go, and he didn't. You saw what happened. Oh, and Jim misses. Not so much that he... I can hardly talk. Not so much that he missed. It's just that Adonis put the brakes on. Brunzell was already in the air to deliver a flying dropkick. And you saw what happened. Oh! Into the fence. Now Brunzell gets his head right. I'll tell you. The galvanizing on this. Look at, he gets it again. The galvanizing on this, on the wires of this fence, has a tendency to bead up in spots, depending on which side it was dried. And there are little barbs sticking out. It's like getting hit with a barbed wire or a wood rat. Leg out. A kick from behind. Down to one. A throw off by Brunzell. Greg Gagne almost falls in the ring trying to get at Adonis. Get a chunk of him anyhow. And to the knee. The reason I stress the fact that there's those little bumps or barbs. Look, oh, now Brunzell's bleeding. Brunzell caught that fence. The body bite, and he lets Ventura have it. Ventura, I don't know what he's wrestling on, instinct. Now, Brunzell, Brunzell is reading, really, looks like he is quite injured. Brother. A forearm smash. Greg Gagne would like to get in there and help out his partner. Brunzell awfully close to Ventura and Adonis between them. And Brunzell gets a hold of Adonis. I tell you, I don't know why they have these. These are very dangerous matches. Uh-oh, look out. One, two, throw off by Brunzell. Greg Gagne ready to dive in to help his partner. Well, I tell you, I think all four of these men are cut badly. Or is Adonis just been flagged? Or has he been? I don't know. A flying drop kick, Brunzell. The crowd, oh, and Greg Gagne fresh for the rest in there. Oh, brother, he almost came down on his head. Into the fence again. Ventura gets it. He gets grabbed. Adonis, oh, and he goes all the way over. Look at this, Greg Gagne go to work. Listen to this crowd. There it is, the sleeper. Brunzell's gagged back to his corner. Greg Gagne with a sleeper. From behind, Ventura lets Greg Gagne have it. Brunzell goes after Ventura. Adonis is going to... Nope, what's he going to do? He's crawling out of the ring. No! From the top of the cage! Oh, good Lord!
And trying to talk over the crowd. Greg Gagne, you pinned him. A protect by Jim Brunzell, the winners, Greg Gagne and Jim Brunzell. The high flyers over Adonis and Ventura. The capacity crowd.
You know that old saying, you get what you pay for? Well, whoever said that, obviously, never heard this. Right now, you can lease a new 99 Mitsubishi Galant DE for just $209 a month for 39 months. That's the best new car in its class, according to Kiplinger's magazine, with one of the lowest lease payments in its class. Yeah, so Sometimes you get what you pay for.
Your morning commute without Splash windshield washer.
Hey, buddy, get off the road!
Your morning commute with Splash windshield washer. Next time, use Splash windshield washer and Splash de-icer for safe driving in ice and freezing rain and a relaxing commute.
Two different matches, Santana and Martel, and then the East-West connection.
Very different, very different. It was science and brawling, one or the other.
Maybe we can get the governor here on the program one of these days.
Well, Jesse, well, how about it? They'd love to see you here and talk about it and defend yourself about, you know, some things that we've had to say. And come on down here, and we'll have a verbal wrestling match.
Well, we want to thank all the people here in the state of Minnesota and all the local establishments. Man, it's going crazy over the AWA legends. Club O's, they had a brunch and lunch with the Crusher. Last week at Runyon's, you and Mad Dog Bashan.
Right. And don't forget Mad Dog Jack Farrell, who's big one up at Bay Lake, along with his tag team partner, Dr. Jerry Foley. Yeah, they're still around. And, it was a dandy. They're still talking about it, and it's been two, three weeks already.
Well, next week, we've got a surprise for everybody. But before we get to that, run, don't walk,
to get your ticket.
No, get to your local Mitsubishi.
Go ahead,
get there. That's where the people need to go. Get down to your dealership. They got some great deals today. But next week, take a look at what we've got for you.
Recognize me? I'm the Mad Dog, and I'm coming back next week on the Legends of the AWA. You better be there to watch it, and remember, it's a dog-eat-dog world.
AWA Legends has been brought to you by your local Mitsubishi dealers.